touches this topic because not a lot of people like care for them. But from when I was researching, I found out that like 15% of people care for them. Like they do something about it for them. So that's why I chose it. Maybe I like animals too. Okay. Animal abuse. The definition for most of you people is an inflection of physical pain and suffering and even them death. And punishment of abusers is when you like someone hurting them, like harm them. And taking to justice like for what they have done to them. I have 6 pictures of animals that are mostly abused of people, like cows. My mentor told me that cows are abused because they're not giving milk to people, like to get money from it. That's why they hurt. They like teach them like a lesson. So that's why they hit them. And dogs, like they put them to fight with other dogs to get, in order to get money from it. And the sheep, because they want to make clothes from it, like cold and for the weather. And cats, like they hit them because they don't listen to them. That's when they punish them for. When they punish their children, like hit them, because they haven't done, like they do something about it. So that's what they do. For horses, they're like that skinny because they punish them with no food and no water for like years, months, and they still like with no energy. And elephants, they abuse them too, because they use them as in circle zoos and fighting too, or with other elephants. So we should punish people that do not climb up on harm to them. So we should like help them out. I'm gonna tell you a short story about personal. When I was like in 8th grade, me and my brothers were playing soccer, and then the ball went over to my neighbors. And when I went there, this person grabbed a cat like in their neck and started beating up like if they did something really bad. And then I was really mad, and I started crying because I don't like people doing that to animals. So I started crying, but I got the ball, and like the ball is really like hard, so I threw it to him in his face. And I was scared because he was gonna go, like, I thought he was gonna do something. So he didn't let the cat go. And then I started running because he was chasing. So he still grabbed the cat and then running with it. And then I went to my house, and then he got there, and he was like, he told my brother that I didn't want to talk to my parents about what I did to him. And then I explained them, like, what they did to the cat. And then my brothers were like, oh, just leave the cat, you know, she doesn't like seeing those kind of stuff. So that's why I guess she did that, because she wanted you to let the cat go. And he was like, oh, well, that's not her business, you know. And I was like, well, I really don't care, like if it's not my business. I mean, someone should do something about it. But like, then he was like, then my brother's like, just let the cat go. My parents won't do nothing to her if you want her to get in trouble from me. So then my brother got him because he didn't want to get cat go. And I didn't know, but I'm allergic to cats. And then I didn't really care if I was allergic. But I got little pimples, and I started sweating and started getting sick. But I didn't know that. And then I told the doctor that I really didn't care if I was allergic to them. I just wanted them to stop hurting them. So then I got this little thing that was always scratching myself. So I left it like that, and I always remember. And I was trying to calm the kitty down because he left. He was like, and I was like trying to like tell them that I was talking to the dad. I was like, "Oh, you know, I'm not gonna hurt you like he hurt you." So I started like petting him, and he started scratching me. Like, I don't know if you can see it, but I started like he started scratching me, and I was like, you know, like I was it hurt, but like at the same time I was like I was happy because I did something different. Like I tried to help them out. So that's like my story, saving the kitty and getting like sick. The laws that are from different countries. In Alabama, cases like dog fighting, they punish men with $1,000 that they had to pay, and 6 months in prison. I mean, for me, I think that's not enough. I mean, the money is good, but punish. I don't think it's like 6 months. Like they should get some more years or months in prison, because you shouldn't do that. Like, you shouldn't hurt the animal. In Arizona, the case of kill and harm, they pay the same as Alabama, $1,000, and they go to prison 6 months. And I think that's not enough punishment. So we should like make them a harsh punishment. And in California, cases like any of as killing and burning and harm them, the amount of money they have to pay is $20,000, and in prison 1 year. Like, I think that they should like blow the money and put them more like in jail, like more like amount of. They should like put them in a more like in jail for 2 years, three years or more, because killing is like killing a human being, even though like some people think that they're not human, but they have feelings. Like last time Jeanette said that she likes cats, and Mr. Winnie said that they sense you, they feel you, so why not help them? Like they need help, and they're not like humans, but like they live in things, so we can do something about it. In Florida, cases like run over and kill in shelters, like some shelters that act like they care about them, but they actually don't. Like they hurt them, or when they don't listen as a child that don't listen to their parents. And the amount of money is $2,500 or $10,000 was to that, and punishment 5 years. I was happy for that because that's enough. Like I think that's fair. So we should take the people that abuse animals to justice. Like as a human, you want, if someone is kills your family member, you want justice too. Why not have animals to take justice too? Two famous people that were not arrested, but like they were pointed out as bad people, you know, because Michael Vick was a football player, famous player, and he had a secret group in his own house. He had a group of fighting dogs, pit bull dogs, and they caught him because someone snitched on him, and that's why they got him, and he paid like $2,500 in Virginia, and he went to two years, but he paid his ticket out because, you know, he's a famous person, but police and judge shouldn't let people get them with money, you know. Like, he should do something more. Like, don't let, just because he's famous and he's rich, you shouldn't let that happen either. Like, you should like do something about it, like protect them, you know. And Kim Kardashian too. She thinks that the cat is not hurt. How do you know? Are you not? You're not in their shoes. Like, she's not even in their shoes. Like, they don't know how they feel. So why grab them like that? And And I know a lot of people are famous, they're a fan of her. But I mean, you should see that she doesn't care. Like, she's really happy, like, holding that, like, oh, you know, I'm so proud holding a cat. And they shouldn't do that. She shouldn't do that. Like, famous people shouldn't get away from it. Like, they should have, like, we should punish them too. As they say, like, not pay money, but, like, to go to prison and feel that what they have done is not good. Like, to make them sure that doing that is not good at all. And this graph that my mentor told me to find out, most common victims are dogs. 64% of dogs and 80% of cats. And 80% of other different animals. And commonly abused animals, in 2013, they found that 50% of dogs still was abused. And cats, 60%, and horses, 8%, and other animals, 23%. And then for the research that they experienced on animals in Germany in 2014, mostly are mice, 68%. And then on 2014, the blue one is for beating. Like, they're beating mostly dogs. So everything consists on more. So it shows that we should do something about it to stop the racing, the right, so it can go down and make them justice for the animals too. What animals are primarily used for? The first one, for food. I'm not gonna lie, I eat chicken. But the other animals, like a rabbit, deer, snakes, and pigs. Oh my god, I don't like those. Last time I went to the restaurant, and the food looked so good, like, but it was pig or food, and then I didn't know. But at first I was like, what is it? And I thought it was chicken because I love chicken. So I thought it was chicken. So and they were like, no, it's pig. And I didn't touch it. Like, I was like, oh hell no. And then my parents were like, oh, you have to eat it. And I was like, no, because I don't like it. And then I didn't eat at all. I was like, I'm gonna go to the house and eat pumpkin. Like, seriously, that's not animals. So I was happy about it, but we shouldn't do that. Like, we should punish those people that kill innocent animals, like pigs and fish and other one. They use animals for medical research. And I know it's good. It's for us to be protected, but I mean, they should find another way to inject them. You know, like not to them, to something else that it won't hurt an object. Because animals are not an object; they're a living being, like us, like humans. So we should do something too. That we should punish those people that doing research for them. They use it on monkeys, mice, and rabbits. Those are my transport. I mean, I know it's like some things are heavy and everything, but I mean, for this guy, like, he's young, he has feet and hands, like, he can walk by himself. And he can carry his stuff. Like, why even go and make more heavy to the animal? And I know for elders, I mean, they're you know, like, really old. So, I mean, like, I think that's, like, fair, you know. But, like, for them, we should, like, for the young people, we should, like, do something, like, punish them, too, for doing that. Like, because if they didn't have feet or hands, I mean, I understand. But if they have, like, if they're healthy, strong, why they don't want to talk, why they don't want to, like, walk. So, like, we should do something. For entertainment, people use it as like a Michael Vick used the dogs fighting in order to entertain themselves. Like they don't want to go, like, do something else than rather than see dogs fighting, taking the skin off, bleeding, or get hurt from other animals. And then, so we should do something, too, about them. Those that are, if you see someone hurting an animal, you should defend them, too. And I know sometimes it's scary because, you know, that they might do something to you. And some people think that they're going to go to prison for helping the animal. That's not the truth, honestly. Like, you have to do something about it in order to stop the right to continue more. Should be. And they use it for clothes. I mean, I know some, like, mostly famous people make, pay a lot of money in order to kill some animals. They have a nice dress and a nice shoes, a nice wallet, a purse, and use snake skin to get a belt, purse, knives, and other type of clothes and other use. So we should do that too, like not make them pay for what they're doing too. And I know it's too money for to survive, but I mean, you should find another way to do it, you know? We should do something about that too. I will show you a video of two teenagers that they want to test people and public people, like how many people actually do something about running animals. And there's a fake dog and sounds of dogs they put on.
So we're actually kind of out of time. So we might want to watch the video next time.
Okay.
See if we can get it running. Was this pretty much the end of the presentation?
No, it's just a solution. The solution is to provide and help out animal shelters and volunteer to, you know, like pick up to rescue animals from the streets, because there's a lot of